Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's Mutia Rukwaru, your popular family therapist and relationship coach. This time, I'll talk to you about a phenomena called pyromania. Pyromania is a psychological term, and I feel it's important to talk about pyromania, especially in these times when we are having students burning many of our secondary schools. But I would like to caution you that I'm not talking about that phenomena of students burning secondary schools, because that one will mean, as a psychologist, I try to use other theories to explain theories on corrective behavior and corrective action, of which I don't want at this juncture to talk about. This one, pyromania, is a term which means a deliberate setting of fire. An individual has got an urge to set things on fire. These are the symptoms of somebody who is a pyromaniac, or somebody who is having this problem of pyromania. The person that has deliberate setting of fire, it is intentional. He has intense obsession with the fire. He plays with the fire. He is a pleaser after fire has been lit. And please note, this person does not set things on fire to set, or rather, as a political statement. No. This person does not set things on fire to express anger. This person does not set things on fire as sort of a crime. But this person, when they set fire, something on fire, they get relief. They get excitement after setting things on fire. They are usually excited by seeing these firefighters. They are usually excited by seeing a fire station. They would even dream to become a firefighter. And these people, some of the other characteristics they have is that they even suffer from hallucinations. There can be hallucinations of grandeur. There can be visual hallucinations. They are seeing things. They are hearing voices. They are seeing people who don't exist. They are hearing voices, giving them command. It is also a symptom of a person suffering from this pyromania. And these people, now, realizing these are some of the symptoms, I would just like to talk about some of the causes an individual becoming a pyromaniac. And I'm not talking of a group action like students. So, one of the reasons for someone to get into being pyromaniac is the aspect of depression. Depression can lead to somebody being a pyromaniac. So, when somebody is setting things on fire, it is to get relief from stress and depression. That is one reason for becoming a pyromaniac. The second reason is the aspect to do with the family. Some of these things might be tied up with the family. It might be in the DNA. It might be the aspect of genetics. And so this might be tied up with the family. And now tied up also with the family, it's aspect of upbringing. The overprotection. You would stress your children so much, so they want a relief. In this one, even now at individual level, they might set up things on fire as a relief because of the intense discipline, of very militant discipline. So they are overreacting, overprotective parents. Another one, based even on the family aspect, is the aspect of drug abuse. this taking bangi and other substance abuse, they can end up also becoming pyromaniacs. And then the other aspect is there is what we call the happy hormones, the happy hormones, which I don't want to dwell so much on them. If there is happy hormones, you become happy, you become excited, and you are such a good person. But if these happy hormones get reduced, then there is a likelihood for you now overreacting and setting things on fire, so that you feel as if you are going to become happy and you feel excited about it, but it is because of the reduction of the happy hormones. Otherwise, thank you very much for those who have been supporting my Eureka channel. It's Adampap. For those who have not subscribed, I want to encourage you so that you understand some of these phenomena, like why is somebody a pyromaniac? And please also note, this phenomena is also common, especially for women who have also reached menopause. And surprisingly enough, this pyromaniac can also make some people, either men or women, to get sexual excitement. Thank you very much.